macOS Ventura comes with brand new Waether app. To open the app, go to Launchpad and click on this icon. The app user interface has the same theme and structure as the one on the iPhone. At the top, you have the location's name, current forecast, and today's high and low. The dynamic background changes with current weather and the time of day. The app consists of clickable panels, each showing you a different weather metric for the current forecast. Clicking on each panel gives you more details or shows you a weather metric value over the course of today and 9 days in the future. Clicking on the severe weather panel provides you with more info from the source which published the severe weather alert and statement. The air quality panel provides you with more air quality health information and shows you the main pollutant. The sunrise sunset panel gives you more info on the daylight situation, including the daylight duration for today as well as the average duration for every month for the current location. The hourly forecast panel is scrollable and shows you weather forecast for today hour by hour. If you click on the weather map, it expands, giving you more control and selection. You can see an animated precipitation map, pause and play it, or change the range from 12 hour to 1 hour. You can center your location on the map, change the weather layer to temperature or air quality, zoom in and zoom out, or even move the map. This is what other weather panels show when clicked on. To make the sidebar, which lists all the added locations, visible, click on the Show Sidebar button. To add a new location, type it in the search box at the top right and click on the closest match among the suggested locations, and click on the appearing Add button to the left. To remove a location, right click on it and click Delete. To change Celsius to Fahrenheit or vice versa, click on View in the menu bar and choose one. To enable or disable forecast and severe weather notifications on Mac, click on Weather on the menu bar, click Settings, and check or uncheck the checkboxes to start or stop receiving notifications. By the way, if you ask Siri for a forecast on Mac, it will take you right to this weather app. Please like if this video helped you, subscribe for more tutorials, comment to ask questions, or to give feedback. Thank you.